This electric bike has dual motors and a massive 48-volt, 60-amp-hour battery pack. 32.8 pounds on this battery. Current MSRP is $2,600, but you can find it on sale in the link below this video in the description box. But do not buy the Walkie H9 all-wheel drive electric bike just yet. We need to crack this thing open, take a closer look at it, then take it out for a full review and see if it's any good or not.
He's doing good. You're either going to drop him or drop your bike. You probably value your bike more than my damn dog.
Holy crap.
So right away, we can see it is full suspension sitting on a coil shock. And that massive battery is mounted in the center, which makes for more balanced handling.
Looks like we've got a few other boxes here. And I'm pretty sure that's the absolute worst way to open this bike.
And it is dual motor. We are rolling on mag wheels, which increases the weight over a spoke wheel a bit. On a wheel that's already pretty heavy because it's got a big motor right up here. Plug it in soon. Other side here reveals huge 203mm brake rotors. Probably good to have on a heavy bike. 20x4 CST knobby tread tires. So sometimes these dual motor e-bikes have a hard time getting that power down to the front wheel. It'll be interesting to see how this bike performs with a heavy battery mounted in the middle of the bike. Which, speaking of, let's get the keys. Pop this big boy out of here. My goodness. It is indeed listed as 48 volts, 60 amp hours, 2,880 watt hours of energy. Should make for some huge range. I should mention they do offer this bike in a 40 amp hour version as well. However, on dual motors, we will be consuming energy at perhaps twice the pace of a single motorbike, so we'll see how we hold up today. See how heavy this thing is. 29. Wait, low battery. Come on. Oh man. How ironic. When I have the biggest battery on planet Earth, it's gonna tell me low battery. Pop this guy right on in there, right? Just did the old battery swapperoo. 32.8 pounds on this battery. So the 40 amp hour version would weigh about one third less. And while we're weighing things, let's go ahead and throw this tire up front. The wheel, the tire, the front hub motor clocks in at 22.4 pounds. We don't have this thing out of the box yet, and I already have 50 pounds of weight.
What else are you working with on this electric bicycle?
Nice passenger seat. Check that out soon. Comes with a derailleur guard in case you knock your bike over. It'll protect your Shimano tourney derailleur. Looks like we'll be working with a Shimano cassette. 7 gears. We'll feel out these dual coil shocks soon. Plastic fenders. The rear rack. It's got mounts for your passenger seat. It's got a Walkie branded taillight around back. And the H9 all wheel drive. Of course, is a folding electric bike. So this is a pretty long electric bike.
But the whole thing will fold in half and compact down to a pretty small size.
So you know, if you need to store this thing away in an apartment or something. And if you thought that 48 volt, 60 amp hour battery pack isn't big enough, it's actually possible to stuff another 20 amp hour 48 volt battery in here. That's an option on the Walkie website. You can see it in the link below this video in the description. That would be 80 amp hours at 48 volts. Huge, 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 huge range. And even more weight. Which, if you're gonna be on a bike for that long, you're probably gonna wanna be comfortable. Wonder if the seat is comfortable. It is definitely wide, feels pretty squishy, seems like a good shape. Super thick diameter seat post. What is it? 33.9 millimeter diameter. Just in case that rear suspension sucks and you wanna put on a suspension seat post, you can do that. And we do have a quick release lever to easily adjust the height of the seat. Seat pops up like that so you can get the battery out. Of course, the handlebars have a folding stem. Which, speaking of handlebars, we get round rubber grips with a quarter twist throttle on the right. Here's the horn, we'll check it out in a few. Same 7-speed Shimano shifter we see on like every bike, same controls we see on like every bike. DY Island hydraulic brakes, would not consider it the premium stuff. However, we do have 203 millimeter rotors, so we'll see how they perform. We'll turn on this display in a few, and on the bottom side, boom, we get a USB-C port here to charge a cell phone. It's about time they've upgraded us from 1995. Usually we see a USB port. Typically we see a connector that would be compatible with something like this. Yeah, buddy, we got a USB-C. How about that? I mean, in theory, that would be charging my phone if we get the battery on there. Probably a decently cool feature to have for a long range e-bike you might be doing some delivery on, or you know, something you're gonna be out on for a long time and your phone might die. So of course we get front suspension. We get adjustments with micro adjustments instead of a basic lock unlock. And probably most important for that front suspension is where the weight of the battery is. Since the battery is further back, Sometimes these heavy batteries up on front will make the front suspension bottom out like big time. I think this one will be all right. We'll see when we ride it. And just a few more matters of business here before it's playtime. Check out this charger.
Dang, this is a legit charger. This thing is big. Oh my goodness. Does that say 7 amps?
No, 7 amps of input, 8 amps of output. Boom, that's a good charge rate. Well, pretty fast charge rate. 60 amp hours divided by 8 amp charge rate.
Get that thing plugged in.
That would be about 7.5 hours to charge.
From completely empty to completely full. Oh, we do have a fan on there. Nice. Helps keep things cool.
However, you only ran the battery like half down. You can cut that charge time in half.
And other items included with the bike would be a user owner's manual, headlight, folding pedals, and some basic tools. Check out what they have in here separating the pedals. A Joker card with money on the other side.
I'll show you how bright the headlight is here in just a minute. So once you get this big ol' front wheel on there,
it's probably gonna make you feel a little less excited to fold this bike because you gotta bolt this wheel down. There is no quick release lever because you got a motor on front with some wiring. So it's gonna be a little bit bigger of a folding electric bike. Just make sure you get those anti-rotation bolts set up the proper way, because with all the power on this front motor, you don't want problems with it rotating the axle and ripping the cable out.
Fenders on, headlights on.
And here's a quick look at the 4-piston hydraulic brakes. CY Island, you can see the 4-piston. Inside shows us M4X.
And we get precisely the same on the rear. And it's about time to throw this battery on there.
Ugh. Dang, dude.
Lock it in, fire it up. Close the trunk.
That seat goes really high. Let's go ahead and fire this thing up. Boom. Walkie.
So it is a color display. They ship it at 67%. We get our battery readout in terms of a percent. Always a nice thing to see. We can see its color because we are running on rear motor lit up by the orange.
Wonder how we change that. Let's tap I.
Nope. I shows top speed 35, average speed 29. 2 minutes of ride time on this thing. 1 mile trip.
Those are the settings. I'm gonna tap the power button now. And that does not change the modes. Wonder how we change them.
So we do get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 levels of pedal assist.
How do we change it to dual motors?
Let's try the horn. Bicycle friendly.
Not crazy loud. I'm gonna try and hold the I button.
Boom, there we go. Front wheel drive now. Hold I again and boom.
Dual motor. And whoa, what does that mean? It turned off the, what were those, lightnings? I guess, what would it mean? Would that mean no motors?
We'll find out. So real quick here as a demonstration, everything on max height. I am 6'5". Ugh. So you can make this bike large or small. Seat on max height, handlebars on max height. Here's what my pedal stroke would look like. This is a giant folding electric bike on maximum settings. Whoa. Let me go ahead and drop it down to minimum seat height. I am noticing the battery is gonna kind of get in the way there at some point, about 2 inches from the bottom. Now on minimum height seat, here's what my pedal stroke looks like. Dropping the handlebars on down to minimum. Here's what we're looking like. A little bit of a high step, not too bad. I got plenty of room there.
Then of course you can bring a passenger once you throw this on, like so. I wonder if there's a place for passenger foot pegs.
Does it have a brake light? Pulling the brake lever, it does light up. Let's flip on the headlight switch. So we do get a light that turns on, and then you pull the brake light, it lights up brighter. Nice safety feature. And of course up front, we get a headlight, which is actually pretty bright. Turns off, turns on. And before we go outside, let's see if we can get ourselves into a little bit of trouble inside. How's this bike pretty good? Oh, spin it up. Oh gosh, I can't reach the left brake. Almost had another skid mark. Spinning the back wheel up. Ready to go.
Here's what is showing on the dash.
34.
Holding 34. Should I try both motors? That headlight is actually pretty bright.
All right, let's check the weight of this thing. I weigh
209.
And if I pick this thing up, let's move 30 pounds of it.
Or 32 or whatever it was.
See what the verdict is. 293. So what's that?
116 pounds for this bike with the battery in it.
And that's before we add air to the tires.
All right, dude, let's take out the walkie. H9 all-wheel drive. We're gonna bring the manual because there are some features in here like GPS. We'll check it out later. Of course, we're gonna run the Strava so we can track our official range on this huge 60 amp hour battery. It'll be interesting with the dual motors. They say 1000 watts on the rear, 750 on the front.
We'll feel it out.
Sorry, dude, you gotta stay here. You're only 7 weeks old. I'll be right back.
Here's a little peek at the app. We'll check it out as we go.
Vehicle positioning.
So of course, the very first test we're gonna do is a 20% grade. We're gonna run it on single motor only.
Throttle.
full throttle on five. This thing is actually pulling us up on rear motor only, throttle only. There is no wattage output, unfortunately. I don't think I'm gonna make this. So of course, if it can do rear motor only, it will surely be able to do dual motor, but let's go ahead and try front motor. Full throttle, no pedaling, and see what it'll do on front motor. So there is actually a little bit less power on the front motor, which is actually ideal on these dual motor bikes. It's starting to spin out just a little bit, and I'm about to lose my balance, but So I actually find on these dual motor e-bikes, it's ideal for traction to have, you know, a little bit less power on that front motor. Let's go ahead and throw on dual motor now. Obviously it's gonna absolutely decimate. So from a stop here, full throttle now, and barely any wheel spin at all. And this thing is just whipping us right up. 12 miles an hour on throttle only, distributing that power across two. Oh my goodness, this thing is pretty powerful. You get a little more traction. And wow, got a little bit of wind out here today. Hopefully it's not too much interference on the microphone. Tilt that display towards you guys. So can we see this display through the polarized sunglasses? You guys know before me. The answer is no for me. I cannot see that at all anymore. So I'm gonna bump this thing down to pedal assist one here. Give it a little throttle to get rolling here. Now we're gonna start pedaling. Now this is a cadence sensor, I believe. And holy smokes, on dual motors, this thing really gives you the juice there. So we're already up to 18 miles an hour. It cuts us off on pedal assist one, dual motor. I wonder what happens if we flip it on down to single motor. So holding this, actually it took the lightning bolt off the wheels. I wonder what that even means. So you still get power actually. I don't know, we'll find out later. So putting on rear motor only, I wonder what the speed will be it'll take us up to. It's actually about the same, 18 miles an hour there, 19, wow. Now in the manual, it says you will get better range if you just run this thing on single motor. So if you don't need dual motors, maybe, you know, you can save yourself a little bit of range by not using both motors. So pedal assist one, 19 miles an hour. Let's try pedal assist two. Yeah, definitely feel a little bump up in power there. We're already on gear number seven, pedaling at about 23 miles an hour, according to the onboard, which we'll verify with GPS here shortly. I don't think I'd want to pedal much faster than this. Definitely feel a little bit of bob on that rear suspension. So, you know, it tells us that it's working, which is nice. So let's try pedal assist three. So, all right, now I'm just thinking this thing has a huge battery and we should be able to get some pretty epic range out of this. But more importantly than that, we should be able to put down some big power numbers for a long time. So yeah, I'm pretty much out of pedal gear at 27 on pedal assist three. I would not want to pedal any faster than this. And going around this corner, I love these mid-mounted batteries. The battery on this thing is huge, but I love the position of it. It is like perfectly ideal for cornering. And we are coming up on 32 miles an hour. Let's give these brakes a test and see if we can not go flying through this intersection. Whew. So seats high up. I love the ride position of this folding e-bike. This thing actually fits me. Most folding e-bikes are like way too small for me. But of course you could drop that seat way down. I find it interesting that they give us this rear seat, but there's like nowhere to put your passenger's feet. I don't know. Is there like some pegs or something you can clip on there? The seat on this e-bike is wide and it's nice and comfortable. Let's try this suspension off-road just a little bit. So it's actually fine. I can tell that it has suspension and it's, oh man, hit some puddles there. It's been raining here for like 3 days straight. That's fine, you know, I'd say, you know, mostly keep this thing on the street, but let's try pedal assist five here. What kind of speeds can we hit? Flipping on out into traffic here. Woo, this thing's got some power, man. So I'm saying 29 on throttle only, 31 on throttle only, 32, 33, 34, 35. I felt the motors kind of start to cut power there at 35.3, according to the onboard. We'll check it with the GPS soon. All right, so let's give it a little 0 to 20 acceleration. Throttle is on the right, keeping your left hand free for signals or a GPS in your left hand. So we'll test the 0 to 20, ready, go. So no wheel spin really on the front, just a very slight amount of wheel spin. 15, 20. Man, this thing cooks, dude. Wow. This is faster than I was expecting it to be. So they say 750 watt front nominal, 1000 watt nominal on the rear. Those peak numbers are higher. So if you want to go a little bit easier on the power, you can throw it on front motor and let's see what that'll do now. Oh yeah, I can feel just one motor, especially the front motor. Definitely makes it a little bit more gentle on the power delivery, which are probably best, I would think, in theory, for range. But on front motor, it's pulling us up this hill here. Totally fine. The pull leash chopper is distracted. Let's go ahead and do a top speed run. Both motors on, pedal assist five, throttle only, ready, go. Full throttle. A little bit of traction, spin on that front wheel, not much. Oh gosh, we're gonna have to tap the brakes here for the CTS. Pulling out in front of the Porsche. And
this. Hey, we both have mid-engine bikes, bro. Our cars. 27, 29. Dude, this thing freaking cooks, man. 31 on GPS. 32 on GPS. 33 on GPS. Please stop, bro. So it is showing 33 on GPS. 32, 33 on GPS versus 35 on the onboard speedometer. So I'd say fast enough, dude. Just want to say back there in that Porsche Cayman passed us on the left side with all the commotion with this Cadillac. That Porsche Cayman has its engine mounted like in the middle of the cars, the mid-engine, the weight of the cars in the middle, kind of like the same setup as like what we got going on here. The majority of the weight is like mid-mounted. I mean, why do you think they do that on a Porsche Cayman? It's the performance benefits. So the battery is currently showing 100%. Not sure if that's true or a couple miles into this ride. We'll see what the range is like though. They're looking for us after that high speed run. All right, let's go ahead and drop a few gears here and try and do this uphill sand on the smaller 20-inch wheels. Oh yeah, totally fine with the all-wheel drive. Sometimes 20-inch wheels don't do excellent in the sand compared to 26-inch wheels, but on dual motors with these grippy tires and going over that rough stuff back there, this thing's totally fine, man. It's a pretty good bike, dude. I'm liking this one. Let's see if we can get it to burn out a little bit. Turn the wheel here in full throttle. No, so it actually like gives you the power delivery kind of like more gentle on that front wheel in the beginning, which is great for, you know, not burning out, tearing up your front tire and losing control of your bike. Totally just lost it there. Oops, that's why it's good to wear some gloves.
Maybe a hard hat.
Check it out. We got the derailleur guard there. So in the case you do knock it over, you're not gonna mess up your derailleur. Oh gosh, boys, that might be coming for us. Nope. Let's go try that. Okay, so actually between the two dual motor modes, the ones that has the lightning on there, I would say feels more peppy, more powerful. And when it doesn't have the lightning bolts on the wheels, it feels a little bit less peppy. So you can conserve a little bit of battery. So let's go ahead, drop it a couple gears here on the boardwalk. That rear suspension really does make quite a big difference. And pop on out here on the sand, dual motor, highest settings, pedal assist 5. We're gonna do throttle only. I know this thing's gonna be able to do it, throttle only. Suspension feels a little bit rough riding out here on the hardback sand, but this motor is having dual motor is having absolutely no difficulties whatsoever plowing through the sand. It is a little bit more hard-packed than usual because it has been raining for like 3 days here. But full throttle, man, this thing's got a lot of power. And let's go ahead and run it up this hill. We do have the knobby tires on the front, so hopefully the front motor does not spin out on me. And try and get up here, throttle only. Yeah, it's a pretty heavy bike, dude. So, you know, I'd probably do a little bit better if it had taller wheels, but this thing is not struggling at all, dude. Just crushing it. 15 miles an hour, throttle only. A little bit of a harsh ride. Let's go back here, shoot a little bit of ridiculous B-roll. This thing, let's just stop actually in the sand. Stop, completely stopped, full throttle, no pedaling. Yeah, man, this thing dominates. Oh, that ride is pretty harsh right there though. Dude is angry over there, man, throwing that skateboard. Whew, am I safe over here? I think I'm gonna move locations here. Bike is definitely just chilling here, buried in the sand, no kickstand. Wonder if we can just hop on this thing and torque our way out of it. So, this is 5. Yeah, buddy. That was throttle only. Talk about digging yourself out of a hole, bro. Dude, if they can do 2 people on that bike. They said it's fast. I'm saying if they can do 2 people on that bike, we can do 2 on this one. Look at the balance, look at the balance. Keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. All right, dudes, let's go try it on the California incline. My goodness, is that a lot of doggies, some tail heavy doggies. That cat was chilling, dude. So dudes, as I'm riding this bike, the thing I'm noticing about it is this bike does not feel sluggish at all for a 60 amp hour battery pack e-bike. A lot of the big 48 volt, 60 amp hour battery pack bikes I review, they just kind of feel a little bit sluggish. a dual motor completely eliminates that. So now what we're gonna do is try it on the California incline, the top of that cliff. As you already know, it's a 12% grade, 85 foot climb. We're sitting at 93% battery. But actually before we go up the California incline, let's take a look at the app here. So there is an app, shows us the battery is 93% right now. And the cool thing about this app is there is the vehicle positioning thing. So I just click on that, it pulls up exactly where we are. So, you know, if you lose your bike, you know, maybe your bike gets taken, you can in theory, you know, track it on down. Shows we're exactly over here by the Santa Monica Pier. Kind of skimming through some of the other stuff here, I don't really see like a way to set, you know, your pedal assist speeds or anything. That would be cool if they had that. I don't know, maybe they'll update that in the future. This is the basic Key Disp app, super basic. Rolling on to the loop-de-loop here, pedal assist 5 will do full throttle. Well, see if we can maintain control on full throttle. It's a lot of power. Yeah, we can't do full throttle really, but yeah, this thing has absolutely no problem climbing this hill. Throttle. Loud bike. We got a quiet bike here. So let's whip it around this corner here, and we'll test the brakes when we get to the bottom of the California incline. Try not to crash into this little sign here. Full throttle, so 5. 10 already, 13, 15, 19, 20. So we're already hitting 20, 30 miles an hour down here at the bottom, 24. And we're pulling, 27, 28, 29. Cooking, dude. We are cooking, 29 miles an hour. So we'll whip it on around here and try the brakes at the bottom. So they are 203 millimeter, four piston hydraulic brakes, 29, 30. 32. The levers are DY Island, which are definitely like a budget brand, but the way they feel in my hand, we'll go ahead and give them a bit of a pull here. Oh yeah, dude, they got good stopping power. I pulled them definitely quite a bit ahead of time here, but oh yeah, man, they feel nice. So let's just pretend for a minute you're a little bit out of control, going about 20 miles an hour. You need to come to a stop quickly. Can the walkie do it? Of course it can. I mean, that's a lot of weight coming to a stop at the four piston hydraulic brakes on the 203 millimeter rotors. It gets the job done. Dang, you could see the tires skidding just a bit there. So after around 15 miles, we're sitting at 85%. We're gonna head on home, check the final range, but first let me leave you my final thoughts on the walking H9 all-wheel drive electric bicycle. MSRP on this electric bike is $2,600, which is a bit pricey, but it is on sale in the link below this video for quite a few hundred dollars off that. You just click that link in the description box, so it'll take you over to the order page. You can see the current price. And if you did buy it through that link, it would help support my reviews on Tail Heavy TV. I greatly appreciate your support. Might even have a little coupon code down there for you. All around, I mean, this is a big bike, and it's got big power, big range. This is big, big everything, but you can fold it up, tuck it away nicely in the corner of an apartment, or throw it in the back of a car since it is folding. I like the position of the battery mounted on the bike, helps with the handling. Definitely the shorter wheels help with the handling as well. As a taller dude, I really like that. I can raise the seat up, and this bike actually fits me pretty well. I mean, dual motors, this huge battery, we should get some huge range and also maintain huge power for a long time. And with that power spread out through those two motors, I mean, it really puts down the power good. All around for the money, I do feel that you get a good value on the Milwaukee H9 all-wheel drive. Let's head on home, take the final numbers on the range.
No way, dude.
Mile away, didn't you? I did.
Take a look, didn't you?
How the little dog is doing?
He's doing good. Would you look at him? Awesome. Silky, you know what I mean?
I'll look at him. I'm just looking at him.
I can't toss him to you though.
No.
You're either gonna drop him or drop your bike. Out of your bike more than my damn dog.
Dude is a legend. Would you look at him? Throwing the Raiders jersey over here, driving in the fast lane. The beauty of these big batteries, man, you can just keep running them hard for a long time. Pop in behind this Volt with our Volts, which I wonder how many volts we're sitting at now. All right, dude, just rolling up on 18.12 miles, hour, 24 minutes ride time, 12.8. 2 mile per hour average speed. Oh, I should mention today I was like running throttle only dual motor. You know, I maybe pedaled 1% of the time. So battery is showing 75%. So on these big batteries, you know, I have gotten over 100 miles of range. Now that was running a single motor. You know, if we just take this number, multiply it out by 4, that would be around a little bit less than 80 miles of range. So we are running dual motor on this e-bike. You're probably gonna get a little bit less range than a single motor e-bike, even if you run it on single motor, just because of that extra rotational mass. blast you got going on, extra weight. So in general, you know, big bike, big range. You can even throw on an extra 20 amp hour battery pack in the frame there, which would make it a 80 amp hour 48 volt bike, even bigger range. So, you know, in general, if you're looking for something that's peppy and fun and also is gonna get huge range and you don't mind weight, I think this is a good option. So if you do want to buy one of these bikes, buy it through the link below in the description box. It'll give you the best price on it. However, if this is not the kind of electric bike you're looking for, why are you still watching this video, bro? Go watch this one.